problem is in the brain. If you hate math, math is not the problem. Problem is in the brain. Let's see how. This, you don't.
Hello, in this video, we will discuss why mathematics is difficult for some people. As we know, math is used everywhere. You can see the use of math in the every single field, whether it is science, technology, medical, or even in the hypermart shops for the calculation. We are using mathematics today everywhere. What? For some people, math is like a phobia. People hate math. What is math? It is nothing. Science of numbers. Numbers from 0 to 9. Simple. But for some people, it is a phobia. Okay, do you know what is this? Or hope you know this one. If you know this, then please comment below. Okay, let's move forward. Do you know why some people hate mathematics? You know? Why some people just hate math? Why? So in this video, I will answer. What? Why? How? That is, what is the problem in learning math? Why it is tough for some people? And how to fix this problem? So let's start this video. First, we will understand why people hate. Here, they can hate anything, like they can hate any person, something, okay? So what is the reason why people hate? Suppose, why people hate somebody? Please take a paper and write down the reason, one single reason why you hate somebody. I'm giving some reasons here. You can write your own reason, okay? Maybe they don't like the person behavior. Maybe that person is confusing or different from other. Maybe it can be a reason. You can write down your own. Maybe that person did some harm to you. That's why you hate somebody. You know, always remember, whenever there is hate, anger, fear is behind that. There is a fear behind that. Now let's compare this with math. You know, again, now for mathematics, write down one single reason why you hate math. That was for a person. Now you will write a reason according to you. What is the reason why you hate math? It is complex, it is difficult, or it is confusing, or you found some difficulty to solve the equations problems, or you never get any good marks in the math. I don't know the reason why you hate math. I just give the list of some reason that could be the reason why some people hate math. Maybe it's complex, difficult, confusing, not able to solve, or you never get any good marks in the math. That's why you don't like it, you hate it. Then same as you can see here, why we hate somebody, because we don't like their behavior. That person is confusing or different. Same, we have problem with math. It is complex. It is difficult. We are not able to understand this. It is confusing. We are not able to understand the equations, symbols, even the formulas, how to solve this. It is difficult to solve. And even in the real life, when somebody did some harm to you, you will hate that person in some manner. Same, you never get good marks in the math. You will just hate it because you never get any good marks in this subject. According to you, write your own reason That's just the list I created according to just people why they hate math. For some people, math doesn't make any sense. They don't understand what is this. So in this video, we will clear this. Why? In mathematics, what we have? 10 digits from 0 to 9. Simple. Again, I'm saying in math, we have 10 digits. Only 10 digits from 0 to 9. Whatever number you will create, whether it is in lakh, crore, million, we will create that number using these 10 digits from 0 to 9. So in math, we have just 10 digits. Done. Now we have some operators. Digits, we can perform some operations. For that, we can use different math operators. Done. Next, symbols. We can also use some symbols in the mathematics. You can see the different types of symbols. Hope you know about this one. That is the integral symbol, right? Okay, let's move forward. We have digits, operators, symbols, and alphabets. You can see, find the value of x, find the value of y, and like that. So we can also use alphabets. So in math, what you see whenever you open a mathematics book, you can see just a combination of something in the book. That is a question, answer, formula. That is nothing. We're just a combination of digit, operators, symbols, and alphabets. Nothing special. Just digits, operators, symbols, and alphabets. For example, here you can see we have a question for you. Please tell me the answer. 2 plus 2 is equal to what? Do you know? I know you know. And instantly your brain will reply 4. That's the correct answer. Done. Let's try another question. Difficult one. Do you know what is 2 plus 6? Instantly, again, you will reply 8. Right? That's 8. Let's try another one. This time we will try a difficult one. Let's see. Now, you will take some time to add these numbers, and after that you will reply 67. Done. That's also right. Great. Now this one, here we used multiplication operator. 45. That's cool. Next, again you will reply within few seconds 4. Yeah, that's great. Next, now you will take some time, you know. Yes, we will take some time, and after that you will reply this. Yeah, that's great. Now let's try another question. Please solve this question. Now you will take little more time. Why? Because we have multiplication, and we have 7 digits. Even we are going to multiply this, it will take time. So you will take some time, and after some time you will reply this. Done. Now let's solve this one. For this, you will take a lot of time, or within some time you will solve this. Okay, do you know why you were taking lot of time in solving this one and this one? Because, okay, let's see this one. So when I asked you 2 plus 2 is equal to what, you instantly replied 4. That was not you. Your brain instantly replied answer is 4. And next time when I asked this question, Again, that was not you. It was your brain that replied 8. Why? Why your brain instantly replied? Because you did a lot of practice of these questions in the childhood, and it is easy for your brain to understand what to do here. Simple addition. When you were a kid and at that time, when first time you tried to solve this, it was tough for you. It was just like, what is this? For your brain at that time, it was like, what is this? When you did a lot of practice, now your brain can easily reply that it is 8. Even your brain can easily reply 67. After some calculation, your brain can reply 45, 4. And this one, why? Because your brain is trained for such type of problems. You did a lot of practice, a lot of questions, even you were doing from the first standard. That's why you can instantly reply, because your brain is trained. And even for this, you, after some time, after some calculation, you can easily answer this. Problem is in the brain. If you hate math, math is not the problem. Problem is in the brain. Let's see how. Okay, do you know what is this? Hope you know. What is this, you know? Why we are using this? How we can use this? I'll always focus on what, why, and how. So whatever you are trying to learn, always ask yourself, what is this? Why I'm learning about this? And how I can use this? Suppose your brain don't know about this, then it is tough for you. If you don't know, what is this? You don't know means your brain don't know what is this. Here you is equal to your brain. Here your brain don't know what is this. Your brain don't know why we are using this. Your brain don't know how we can use this. Therefore, it is tough for you, for your brain. It is tough for you. Now, suppose this is omega symbol, and we can use in here. Suppose we teach our brain, anyhow, our brain come to know about this symbol and where it is used, then your brain will instantly reply, it is easy. When it is not trained, when your brain don't know about it, it is tough. When once it know what is this, it is easy. Let's try something. Okay, you know what is this? U means your brain. Your brain don't know what is this. Your brain don't know what is this. That's why. That's strange for your brain. Your brain never did any practice of these symbols. It's not you who don't know. It's your brain. Your brain has no record about these symbols. So keep calm and train your brain. It's not that much tough. You need to just train your brain. You can see the math equations here. This is for area of circle, binomial theorem, for your series, sum of series, or the expansion of series. You know, if you will train your brain, then it can easily solve anything. If you have lack of practice, then it is tough. Here you can see, as I told you, math is nothing but just a combination of digits, symbols, number, and alphabets. As you can see, alphabet N, X, digit I, X, space symbols, operators. You can see it is not that much tough. Once you will practice, your brain will feel relaxed and it will instantly reply. For example, here you can see, here this is integration, this is differentiation, this is simple equations. Just train your brain about this. What is this? Teach your brain. I'm gonna train your brain. What is this? How this work? For example, we want to calculate the mean. You know what mean, mode, median? So we will simple just calculate the mean. So we have this series here from I to N, xi and n. We have a series, this. Next, what is the value of n? That is 5. Why? Because we have 5 numbers. So the value of n is 5. Done. Now we will put the value of n is 5 here. Now we'll calculate I from 1 to 5. That is x1. We have summation symbol. That is plus sum of series. x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 up to 5. Done. Then divided by 5. It's simple. Just train your brain. What is this? Train this. Like in the childhood, you train your brain to learn the digits, tables, alphabets, like that. Whenever you're trying to learn anything, train this. What is this? Teach it. This is just a simple equation, how we can solve this. As you know, those different stages of learning mathematics from childhood to higher engineering. In the starting, we learn just counting from 1 to 100. Then, when we are comfortable with this counting, then we will start addition. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3, 4 multiply, like this. Then we have some simple math questions like logic, reasoning, formulas. A plus B square, like this. A plus B whole square. And we have some factor, polynomial equation, trigonometry, function, profit and loss, probability, geometry, and plus 1 and plus 2 we have matrix set, relation, function, integration, differentiation, differential, and different type of algebra. And even in the higher mathematics we have engineering math, discrete math, and boolean algebra, numerical methods. Nothing is wrong with mathematics. Just practice math as much as you can. As we all know, practice makes a man perfect is a proverb which tells us the importance of continuous practice in any subject to learn. If you want to learn something, anything in the world, doesn't matter. Whenever you are trying to learn any new language, skill, subject, you need practice. It's not that never blame your maths teacher that there is a problem in their teacher. Problem is in the brain. Your brain is not trained. So first, train your brain. Teach it, train it. After that, it's your responsibility to train your brain and do practice as much as you can. It's not tough. Nothing is tough. In the beginning, everything is tough. Once your brain is trained, it becomes comfortable with something, then it is easy. So don't think that your math teacher is a problem or math is not a good subject. Nothing is wrong with your teachers and subject. Problem is lack of training. So you need to train your brain to understand this. Your poor brain is asking you for help. Train it. It's your responsibility. You know what is this now? Omega. You will command this. You know, you will command this. What is this? Once you don't know what is this, then this is tough. And once you will come to know, that is, your brain will come to know, what is this? It is easy. So as I told you in the beginning of the video, that I will answer what this. So what is the problem in learning math is lack of training. Your brain is not trained. Why it is tough for some people? Because their brain is not trained. How you can fix this problem? You can train your brain. You can learn the basic fundamentals. You can do a lot of practice. Nothing is tough. Lack of training. Now here you will train your brain to learn this, to understand this. What is this? And as I told you, it is complex for your brain. It is difficult for your brain. Your brain is confused when it sees certain type of equations, formulas, how to do this. Your brain is facing the problem to solve the difficult equations. You never get good marks in the math because you never did practice. You never helped your brain to learn math. So it's your responsibility to train your brain. Again, I'm saying. So that's all about this video. As I told you, math is fun. It is not difficult. Lack of practice makes it difficult. So practice as much as you can and have fun with math. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.